Well, you're in the business, of course, of selling homes in the high and middle segments of the market. Give us an update on the kind of demand scenario we're seeing in the property market in Kenya right now.
Well, certainly the demand is seeming to shift a little bit downwards, with more buyers and tenants looking for smaller, sort of more affordable properties. And I think we're beginning to see a bit of strain in the upper market with the large homes, the large townhouses, which are beginning to see a little bit of a decline in both prices as well as rentals.
Just last month, though, we saw data coming through that showed that housing prices rose by 8.8% year on year in the third quarter, but rental income fell back 3.6% as housing supply grew. So there seems to be somewhat of a divergence in trend that's actually playing itself out here.
Yes, there certainly is. The rental market hasn't been growing as strongly as the capital sort of growth in the market itself. Again, this is, you know, largely due to the fact that already in Kenya there's a very large proportion of income spent on rental as it is. With the current sort of inflationary pressures, that's becoming even much stronger. So we're seeing that rentals are beginning to become quite strained in the market.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a look then at who's buying, because, you know, this follows on from decades of underinvestment in the Kenyan property space.
Yes, the market that had been buying sort of in the quarters run up to this was mainly the middle market. We'd begin to see a lot of more young professionals coming into the market. This last quarter has certainly witnessed a change, because what's happening is with the change in the interest rate markets, that's putting strain on the mid market. And it's almost becoming a case of the people who can afford to buy are the cash rich, really. So upper-end investors who have money available, or even middle income who can raise larger deposits to offset the kind of mortgage repayments that they need to make.
Let's touch in on that interest rate scenario that you've honed in on there, because we've seen this week interest rates being hiked 550 basis points, this following a 200 basis point rise at the last meeting. What shift are you expecting? Because this kind of performance we're seeing could turn very quickly as financing becomes expensive moving forward.
Correct. I think the biggest implication is really going to be to the mid-market. And this was a market that had been sort of just started, kicked off. It was growing quite well with mortgages available to the buyers, the construction financing available for developers. I think this kind of hike in interest rates is going to lead to sort of a wait and see kind of an approach, a postponement of development as well as buying decisions, because it's making it less and less affordable.
Yeah.
Again, with general inflation, construction costs going up, development margins are becoming quite tight. So developers will sort of be forced to relook at the way that they do things. But I think I'll see a bit of a wait and see approach, especially with the buyers.
How's that coming to bear on the property market as an investment target? You know, what appetite are we looking at out there? And let's differentiate between domestic investors and foreign investors.
I think the perception, certainly from a domestic point of view, is that property is still a better long-term holding. It's not really in Kenya been a speculative kind of market. It's, you know, the Kenyan approach to home ownership has very much been long-term. So it may cause a slight slowdown in terms of momentum, not necessarily in price. I think just you'll find the domestic market waiting a little bit to make investment decisions. From a foreign perspective, you know, the year has had a generally flat kind of growth in the property market. But I think that it still remains much better in investment class, even compared to other countries' investments market. Well,